Welcome again from my side. My name is Mart Noorma. I work at Tartu University, Faculty of Science and Technology, associated professor there and vice dean for studies. And also part-time I work at Tartu Observatory, which is the Estonian space research center located close to Tartu. And today I tell you a little bit about Estonian space projects and mainly about Estonian first satellite, ESTCube-1, which, as you can all see, is currently nicely located in the southern part of the Atlantic Ocean. So this is live image from outer space, and you can see the altitude of the satellite is 675 kilometers, and the speed currently is 27,055 kilometers per hour, which is approximately 7.8 kilometers per second. But to start my presentation, I would like to show you a couple of videos. And the first one is a video that every satellite developing student in Estonia would like to, or is ready to watch for hours. Because this what you see is a launch of the first Estonian satellite, ESTCube-1, on board of the brand new European launcher, Vega. That was historically the second launch of the Vega launcher on 7th of May this year. On board of that launcher, there were European Proba-V remote sensing, Vietnam's RedSat-1 also remote sensing, and the third satellite was ESTCube-1, just tiny 1 liter nanosatellite. But maybe you have heard that currently we live during the time of space revolution, where big, massive space projects with billions of budgets are kind of history, and most of the satellites launched already are tiny nanosatellites. It's predicted that in 2 years, already by 2015, we have more than 100 nanosatellites launched per year. So, if the question is why Estonia is interested in building satellites, then the answer is that Estonia wants to be economically successful, and we need engineers who are capable to develop their own companies at a good international level, with good cooperation with other companies from different on global market. And we need to educate that kind of students. So it's most likely in most of the countries a problem that they don't want to work very hard, and natural sciences and engineering is always slightly less popular than some more fancy subjects to learn. In Estonia, it has been a major problem. Nowadays, it's getting better. And one reason why it's getting better maybe is also the ESTCube project, where more than about 100 students have worked on a CubeSat, on a tiny nanosatellite during last 5 years. But that was the objective, first place, was not just to build another satellite, because there are thousands of them on orbit. But the main reason was to motivate Estonian youth and to show them that in Estonia, one can develop a spacecraft first time ever at the level which is equal to the world space community, to the US, to the Russia, to the Chinese, all these Indians, all these big space nations. And to do, we can be taken as equal partners with all these big space nations. And through this experience, which we try to communicate very hard to all Estonian youth and internationally, to show that anything is possible. But if we look back in history, and this building here is the nicest place of part of Estonian space history, I would like to show you one video that shows the most bright moment of Estonian space history in just less than a minute. This video was done by one of my spacecraft developers students.
Is it online maybe?
Oh, in YouTube. It's all available. Struve, establisher of this building, the first person to measure a distance to another star 200 years ago, among the first persons to measure. he measured the distance to Vega. Topic, first person ever to measure distance to another galaxy. Tartu Observatory, new building outside of Tartu where I work nowadays. Jan Einasto, among the people who discovered the dark matter in the 60s and the structure, theories for structure of our universe. Several radiometers and instruments were launched on Soviet spacecraft in 60s, 70s, 80s. And Cosmos Riik means space nation, Estonia, because this is what we are, at least me and my students are very proud of this year, because the first Estonian satellite was launched just a little bit less than a month, a little bit more than a month ago. So I put some little background here to show how this satellite mission looks like. So when we develop a satellite, then we need to have a really important scientific mission on board, of course. I remind you that the first motivation was to motivate our youngsters. But then we started to look for a really important scientific objective. And we found it together with Finnish scientists, and mainly Pekka Janhunen from Finnish Meteorological Institute, who had just recently discovered technology, proposed a technology for flying in space very fast using only solar wind, not solar light as in case of typical solar sail technology, but electric solar sail uses energy from the solar wind particles. And basically there are many charged, positively charged particles in solar wind which travel at the distance, at the speed of 700 kilometers per second. And if we would put now some big charged object in this wind, then this spacecraft would fly exactly like sailboat with regular wind. So this is a technology that our students decided to prove, because theory is one thing. Can engineers really make it? This is another thing. So of course, that was a motivation. Now we could say to our students that now you are working on the project which will change the future of mankind, maybe, if you are successful. We just need to take the first step. We need to demonstrate that the electric solar wind sail technology works in space. And we have to take many steps before many spacecraft have to be launched before we can really fly in solar wind. The first step is ESTCube-1 satellite, developed by Estonian students together with partners from Finland, Helsinki University, Finnish Meteorological Institute, Jyväskylä University, University of Eastern Finland, partners from Germany, German Space Agency, partners from Sweden, Uppsala University and Swedish Space Corporation, and Italy, Pisa University, and one company next to it. So, talking about technology, I mentioned you already, there is sun, which is nuclear explosions, not only heat, not only light, but also particles from sun are ejected. This is things that causes us aurora borealis, northern lights. The same thing. Luckily, our magnetic field stops it. Otherwise, we would all be dead. But the same thing that is so harmful for people, we try to get into our service. So basically, we can take a spacecraft, and this is now proposed by Pekka Janhunen from Finland. We take a spacecraft, let's say, a couple of hundred of kilograms. We make it to rotate. We have small reels, like spinning, and then we reel out tiny wires from that spacecraft, and then we have that kind of like spider web. Each of these wires are like 20 kilometers long, and they are very thin, like at the level of thickness of human hair. So technology, for a theoretical physicist, seems easy. From engineering point of view, maybe doable, maybe not. So this is what we need to prove. Can we really do it? And then if we have electron gun on board and we push out any electrons from the spacecraft, then the total charge of these tethers will be positive. And this whole spacecraft looks now like one big positive charge in front of the solar wind, which then, because the same polarity charges push each other, then we can take advantage of the kinetic energy of the solar wind. Now, that is a long-term objective. And with this long-term objective, with this spacecraft, basically, theoretically, we can break the world record of spacecraft speed 6 times. Currently, the fastest spacecrafts are flying away from us at a level of 16 kilometers per second. So theoretically, we can achieve something like 100 kilometers per second. And imagine, cheap technology, because no fuel. We don't need to take fuel into space, which is like $20,000 per kilogram. We don't need it anymore. We put spacecraft in space, and we can send cheaply scientific instruments, for example, to Jupiter in 1.5 years, to Uranus, Saturn, in a couple of years instead of tens of years, like it used to be. It's like it's now. So it could really change the way we study our solar system. So that was the background. And how does it look now? ESTCube-1. So our approach in 2008 when we started the project was that we do it ourselves. We don't buy ready components, and we couldn't really buy ready components because it's just tiny. 1 liter, 10 by 10 by 10 centimeters satellite. We need to be absolutely work very hard to fit all the experiment, all electronics, communication systems, guidance systems, everything into this little box. And that was hard work, but you can imagine that little satellite, which has like 7 PCB plates with electronics on it, each of these little plates has science on it worth of 1 PhD. So basically, at least 3 students will get their PhD degrees on development of that, and we have had more than 40 undergraduate and graduate theses defended based on this study. So that is, and we expect to get at the level of 20 international high-level publications, scientific publications, based on this study. So the first step, when we get it up, then we have a camera on board, and the camera is meant actually to monitor the experiment. But at the same time, it can take images of our Earth as well. So from PR reasons, of course, first thing to do was to take photos of our Earth. Then we have to make it spin controlled, and this is something nobody has ever done before, using only electromagnets and Earth's magnetic field. We have to spin it up in controlled way and then release tether, and centrifugal force will push it out. And this way we prove that at least with one tether, at least with 10 meters, we can reel it out in space. So this is the first step. The next step will be taken on board the Finnish first satellite, ALDO-1, in 1 year. So ALDO-1 has several experiments, but one of the experiments is exactly the same as on board of ESTCube-1, but with 100 meter tether. So we take slowly, step by step, but the big mission, big future, would be to have the spacecraft flying to the other planets. And at this point, I only would like to show you our team and small part of our team. As I said, there are more than 100 of us, and the students from all Estonian engineering and science universities, Tallinn Technical University, Tartu University, Estonian Aviation Academy, and the Academy of Life Sciences were involved. And now I think I have said almost everything I could say in a couple of minutes, so I would like to give you a little souvenir. This is official Estonian post stamp, which was released to celebrate the launch of Estonian first satellite. So this is a collector's item.